This is in continuation of the previous class. Okay, we will begin with, the process management, the revision of that, right? And you all people know about the timetable of internal examination when it's going to begin. The detailed timetable will be given to you maybe within a day or two, right? It begins from 20th, am I right? Himarashmi?
Yes, sir.
Right. So all of you prepare, and it is the online examination. Yeah, 5 minutes before the question paper will be given through the Google class or some other different mode depending on the teacher, whatever they tell. And you are supposed to write all the answers in A4 size sheet. Write your USN number, name, right, and course code, course name on all the sheet, right. Scan it and prepare a PDF, and that PDF you will be uploading in a Google class or any mode, whatever that course teacher they inform you. In my case, you will be attaching the PDF to the Google class, right, and doing a submission. Is that okay? Or anything you people wanted to know about the examination? Hello? Himarashmi?
Yes, sir.
Anything else?
Yes, sir. That's okay, sir.
That's okay. Right. You are scanning and attaching a PDF. And one more thing is that whatever the submission you have done so far, everything in a Google class, I'm going to delete that. So all submission, whatever you have done, put it in your Google Drive and attach a short link for that. Today night, whatever earlier submission you have done, I am going to delete everything. Right? Put everything, your submission in your drive and give a short link, except internal exam 1. Right? Because my drive is full now. So I need to accommodate all IA1 papers and all. So your submissions, whatever you have done, please, okay, put it in your drive and give your link. Right? I'll be deleting today night all the things. Is that okay, Himarashmi?
Yes, sir. And sir, some of them want to know the portion, sir.
Yeah. Portion, right. It is there in the syllabus, right? So chapter number 1, chapter number 2, half of that. Or so far, whatever we have done, it is there for the internal exam 1. Right? Except, right, you can get into directory listing implementation, right? Except that, right, remaining all the things are there. Chapter number 1 and 2. Okay? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So far, whatever we have done, except a directory listing implementation, but file attributes, that is there. Process, creating fork, vfork, those things are there. exec, and its variation, it is there. Right? So please look at that right hand side, except the implementation of LSMNSL, but remaining all things are there, right?
Yes, sir.
Is it okay? Okay, now let's try to give a finishing touch for the process management today, and tomorrow we'll get into the memory management, process memory management today and tomorrow, and other aspect of revision kind of things we'll do, except the system calls, because all these days we were doing system calls for the laboratory, right? Shall I get into process management? Right?
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. See ya. And you know that when we go through the different services offered by the operating system in terms of the process, memory management, device management, file systems, whatever it is there, we are studying this at the introductory level, right? The introductory level with the system call, few system calls we are going through. Whereas the details of all these things, you will be studying in the next semester in operating system, right? So these are the two different courses related to operating system. And particularly this, it is about a Unix operating system. So let's get into what exactly we expect you to prepare in about the operating system. But before that, let me take you to the introduction to Unix operating system. Introduction to operating system. That part, what you were supposed to study for the exam. Let me open that. Yeah. Right, introduction to operating system. I have asked you to go through the evolution of operating system, evolution of Unix operating system. Okay, please go through that. And it's a small version of PDF, okay, about the evolution of operating Unix operating system. I have uploaded in the Google class. Please go through that. So far, we have gone through the basic organization of computer system, what operating system are, what they do, how they are designed and constructed, common feature of an operating system, what an OS does for the user and for the computer system operator, and common terminology used in operating system. This as an introduction we have gone through. Just to refer it, right, this particular thing, okay, we have seen the various components of computer system, right, and particularly you can see this as a layers. You have a underlying hardware on the top of that operating system. On the top of that, you have a system and application programs and all, like compiler, assembler, text editor, right? All these things you will see it. And we have focused on memory and its hierarchy, right? We have seen the registers, cache memory, main memory, right? Solid state disk, hard disk, okay, optical disk, magnetic tapes, okay, why for it is required, and how do we compare all these things? We have seen it. Right, so I'm telling you what all things you need to prepare for the exam. So I'm not covering this once again. And also we have gone through the, okay, bit, byte, word, what exactly you talk about the word. Okay, word is a computer architecture's native storage unit, right, made up of one or more bytes, right? Yes, for example, we said computer may have an instruction to move 64-bit word, right, 8-byte word, right, byte, 8 bits, bit, you all about know about that. And also we have introduced the terms like a kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabytes, petabytes. Okay, that's how things gets into. Then why cache memory, right? That we have seen it. Then RAM, okay, EEPROM, DRAM, ROM, what is the role of that? Electrically erasable, programmable ROM, these kind of things, random access memory, right? That we have seen it. A storage system, you try to look into in the form of the, I mean, from the different perspective, like speed, cost, volatility, right, these aspect. And the device driver term, device driver for each device, control to manage I/O, right? Yes. This is how we try to compare the performance of various levels of storage. I'm just referring what we have done so far. Please remember it. Not covering fresh. Right? Register, cache memory, main memory, disk storage. We compare in terms of typical size, implementation technology, access time, bandwidth, okay, MBs per second, transfer rates, right? Then these are the main aspect of comparison that we do. Right? Then what else we have seen? Then data transfer between, right, how do data transfer takes place, right? I/O devices, we heard about, when we have gone through, referred it about the interrupts and all, right? Then we referred it, and the two ways of transferring the things, one is a polling, right, which type of interrupt has occurred, okay, one is a polling vectored interrupt systems and all, we referred it, and we left it there, and we said that when computer organization deal with that, okay, in detail. Then the other thing we spoke about, the a bootstrap program, right, is a loader at power up, okay, or that the reboot time, right? Thus, it is typically stored in a ROM, okay, or EEPROM, generally known as a firmware, right? Loads operating system kernel and start execution. Initialize all aspects of the system. This is what we referred it, right? Then single purpose processor, multiprocessor, okay, systems, right? Then we referred multi-core, right? multi-core in the sense a single chassis containing multiple separate system, right? Having a separate cache, right? And a common memory, right? So this is what we refer multi-chip and multi-core systems. Probably, okay, if you refer your laptop and all, you heard, you see about the core IFA machines, right? Multi-core systems and all, right? Then this all, okay, not required. We have skipped it because not required for you. Next time operating system will...
Sir, some are waiting. Can you admit them?
Yeah, admitted. I've admitted. Right? I've admitted. All are in. Right?
Okay, sir.
Right. Then what are the operating systems? The K, when we were referring to that, it is an intermediary between the user and the hardware. We spoke about that. Right? Underlying hardware, how do you make, how do you store the file, how do you execute a program, right? It will act like a resource manager, right? When we talk about the resource, it is the memory, it is a processor, like a CPU, right? It is a file system, everything we call as a resources, right? So we referred it acts like a resource manager. Resources are nothing but processor, memory, devices, etc. Right? Then when we talk about the multi-programming, right? Single user, okay, cannot keep the CPU and IO device busy all the time. So when more number of programs are allowed inside the multitasking, we call it the multitasking, time sharing, right? And you can look at how the memory layout looks into where different jobs are being placed in the memory and is being managed in terms of who will be using the resources and all, right? This. Then dual mode operating allow the operating system to protect itself. We said user mode, kernel mode and all, right? This is what we have seen it, right? Then process management, the operating system responsible for process management. What do you mean by that? Right, there are different responsibilities like creating and deleting both user and system process. Right, you people know about that one. Right, how do you create a process? Right, so different forms of that we have seen it: suspending and resuming the process, providing a mechanism for process synchronization. That we will deal with in the next semester in detail. How do process synchronization take place? So if we don't synchronize the process, what kind of conflict arise that and all? That we will see it in the next semester, not this time. Even process communication, right? All that things we will see it, okay, next time. Memory management, okay, execute a program. We have seen the memory management, memory layout of a C program. And somewhere we referred that one, okay, startup routines for the C startup routines. Then we said about the exec call, which will load entire image into the memory, right? Right, who will provide a service? It is an operating system, right? To execute a program, load the instruction, right? How it is being loaded as an example of the C program, that also we have seen it, right? Then, right. Operating system services, when you look at that, right, it is a program execution, IO operation, file system, communication, resource allocation, accounting, protection, security. Protection and security, okay, that also we have seen. For example, right, I open a file, right, and I'm owner of that, okay, whether other people, other users, right, can they open, can they read, can they write, can they execute, how to do that one, and how to change all that privileges and all. That also we have seen it, right? As an example, small part of protection and security aspect of that. Right, then a little bit we introduce a command line, right? Then what else? Yeah. Command interpreter, right? We told you about the shell. There are different types of shell. I think probably in the next chapter, okay, we'll begin for the IA2 portion quickly, right? Probably after the internal exam one, we'll begin with the IA2 portion for you, right? Yes. Then system calls, right? Different system calls that we have seen it, right? Then maybe a few example of the system calls, like a fork, exit, wait, we are not seen, exit, we are not seen, fork, vfork, exec, right? Then file related, open, read, write, close, we are seen with example, get PID, get PPID, parent ID, that we are seen, sleep, we are seen it, right? Then change mode, we are seeing it, right? Change mode, with that, how a privilege is for a given file that you can change, right? All that we have seen it. There are many other system calls. Okay, we'll try to manage this partly in next course, next semester also. System calls, process related system calls like a create process, terminate a process, end, abort, load, execute, get process attribute, right? Set process attribute, right? So like this, you will see a lot of things. Part of that we are seeing this time. That's why we have asked you to do programming, right? Hope you all have done it. Except ls-l implementation, right? Rest all the programs are there. Directory listing is there. File attributes are there, right? System calls like a read, open, read, write, okay, close, all that things are there, right? Then we have used stat, lstat, those things are there. Exec, fork, vfork, right? Get PID, get parent PID. These all are there, except integrating all these things in the implementation of ls-l. Except that part, rest all things are there for the IA1. And please give a focus importance on programming aspect more, right, guys? Then coming to the system calls, file management, create a file, delete a file, open, close, read, write. Okay, we have used it. We are used by writing a program. We have used C library as well as system calls, both. And we have written a program. And we asked you to write a program for some case. There are many other things which we have not done, which is not required right now. We'll see it in the next semester. Like, for example, system calls for communications, right? How to do that between the process running in the same system, between the process running in the same system, but they are related, right? Between the process running on two different systems, how to do it and all, that we will see it in the next semester, right? Production part of that, we have written a program also, right? A command, okay, also we have used control access to resource. Get and set permissions for a given file, right? All these things we have seen it, right? The another interesting thing about the system call is that you need to go through the synopsis of the system call, right? There are three important aspects of any system call, four important. One is which library you have to include, name of the system call, various parameters and their details, and return value. Please remember, return values are a very important thing. And also, when we were looking, okay, a return value, we have used something like PID underscore T. Why PID underscore T I have to use, right? Particularly when I'm creating the child process, right? I could have used long int directly. This is okay, mainly for the portability issues. Okay, we referred it, we discussed in depth about this and shown it also, right? Then parameter passing, right, between the user program and the operating system. Okay, there are different things to register, to block of table, through the stack and all, right? Stack, we referred it last in, first out memory. We referred it, right? So they're all short theoretical questions that you may get in the examination. And when you look at the operating system design, right, usually two layers of things that you use it, a good design and implementation, okay, things. One is a policy, other one is a mechanism, right? For example, policy, what will be done, right? What will be done? I want to print, printf, take it, printf. Say, for example, write a system call, right? See, look at that. Many of the system calls, they are implementation dependent sometimes. That you will see in the manual when you refer it. How to see the online manual in Unix operating system, we have seen it. See, the best one is two-layer architecture, right? One is a policy, other one is a mechanism, right? For example, write, right? Write is a policy which allows you to write, right? One minute. I allow all these people, right? The mechanism on how to do it. The mechanism determines how to do something. Policy decide what will be done, right? So how to do it and what to do it. I want to go to Hubli. What to do? What will be done? I have policy. I want to go to Hubli. Right? Mechanism. How to do it? Okay. Is it by vehicle? Is it by train? Is it by bus? How is that? So implementation and the services. Okay. Service, how they are implemented, that you need to look into. Right? So anyhow, we will see this in detail next semester again. Right? Then we referred, the bootstrap loader stored in ROM or EPROM, EE, electrical erasable PROM, right, locates the kernel and loads into the memory, we said it. Sometimes two-step process where, boot block at a fixed location loaded into ROM code, which loads the bootstrap loader from the disk. Common bootstrap loader, we referred it, discussed about the GREB, Grand Unified Boot Loader. Right, sometimes such a small thing will appear for the placement, interviews and all, something like that. We need to look into. Then kernel loads and system then is running. When kernel loads, system is then running. Right? Please look into that. When a power is initialized on system, the execution starts at a fixed memory location. Firmware ROM used to hold the initial boot code. Operating system must be made available to the hardware so that hardware can start it, right? Small piece of code called bootstrap loader stored in the ROM or EPROM locate kernel, loads it into memory and starts it. And the whole process, right, which we referred it. Right? Okay, leave it. Okay, that's about introduction, that about the operating system. What is an operating system that we have seen it? Then on the top of that, as a service, memory process management, we will look into. I told you, when we talk about the, there are two things. One is a program. Program is an executable file. It's created by editor. The program is executed in Unix system by issuing exe system call. Himarashmi, Manoj, can you correlate this with a program which you have written, exec, using exec system call, you have written a program. Can you correlate what I'm talking with the program, what you have written? Himarashmi?
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's great. Then we referred about the kernel, right? Kernel is an operating system which provides service, right? It may be a file system, memory management, CPU scheduling, device, whatever it is there, right? So this is the kernel is the one which directly interact with the underlying hardware. Please look into that. And we referred about the process C program, memory layout and all, we said it. Then C startup routine, exit, right? Kernel, C startup routine, exec. Then command line arguments. Then please look into that. When a program is, this is the one which you people have to remember and likely, right, this may be part of your examination. When a program is running, right, we call as a process. Process undergo different state. So when you go to doctor, what is that happens, right? So you are a new, you enter. You are a new, you have to go and register, right? You get an your serial number. Once you get a serial number, right, you have to wait. There may be a bench there sitting. You may be sitting on a bench. with a card in your hand, right? That is inside, right? So you are ready, but not doctor. Doctor is nothing but a CPU, but doctor is not allocated to you. When a doctor calls you, right, or the assistant to the doctor calls you and you enter into the doctor's room, you are running because doctor is attending you, right? And when a doctor is attending, okay, probably it may so happen that, right, he asks you, did you brought the x-ray which you have taken last week? You say, no, it is there outside. Then he says that one, go outside, get it from your car, which you have kept in a car, you are waiting, right? Then once you bring the x-ray, again you are waiting, sitting on the bench, and somebody says that he has come. Again you enter in doctor's room and start getting advice from the doctor. It may so happen that when everything is over, right, you may exit. Okay, when consultation is over, your case is being terminated, right? This is how the process takes different state when the program is executed. It doesn't execute at one shot, right? When you are opening the file, and opening the file takes a lot of time, why it should CPU should wait for you to open the file? The IO operation, right? So you need to refer it, right? Explain the process state, list and explain the various state of the process. So likely this theoretical question, you may get it, right? So anyhow, what I'll be doing is I'll be preparing a set of question bank today, preferably, right? I'll put it in my Google class. As many as around 30, 40 questions, you can refer it. Is it okay, Himarashmi? Manoj?
Yes, sir.
I'll put it.
Yes, sir.
Okay? And for fifth SAM, yes, sir. Tell me, Manoj.
Sir, as your Google Classroom storage is full, sir, so we are unable to submit our assignments, sir. Yeah. So what we should do about that? As the deadline is tomorrow, sir.
No. Deadline I'll extend. All deadline I'll extend. Okay, whatever submission you have done so far is null and void. I will delete all your submission if at all you are done, right? What you will be doing is, you will be putting in your drive, whatever it is there, right? And you can share that URL, take a URL, okay, copy the URL here. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Right, copy the URL here, upload the URL so that I refer it. Okay, I'm going to delete all submission. You'll be asked to submit everything from the fresh once again, right? I'll delete and I'll extend.
Sir, can you extend
it? Yeah, I'll extend.
As there are, yes.
Yeah, I will extend up to 31st of October.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
I will do it. And I will delete all submission. All submission, whatever you've done, please preserve that in your Google Drive, in your personal drive. Right? It may be Word file, it may be PDF, it may be PPT, whatever it is. And that you can share that one. Manoj, you people know the sharing of that one? You can get a short URL of that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, short URL, you have to submit it to me for every assignment separately. Okay?
Okay,
sir. Except internal exam one. Internal exam yes, one, you have to submit, attach the PDF only. In my drive only directly. For that, I am preparing a space for that. Okay? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's done. Right, 1 minute. 1 minute. Somebody is waiting. Yeah. So, is it okay, whatever you are seeing on the screen, I am just revising what is required. Okay. Manoj, Himarashmi, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Right, that's better. See, every program or the process, it is represented, okay, like a memory layout of a C program. Every process is represented as a structure. Hope you understand the meaning of the structure now. Himarashmi. Yeah, right. What it contains? It contains about the process state, process number, program counter, register, memory limits, list of open files, etc. Right? It includes the process number also. Process ID. Okay, you know about the process ID, know how to get the process ID. Get PID.
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes.
So every program that is running, it contains all this information stored in right operating system until it is being executed, until it terminates, sorry. Right? So process state running or waiting, you have seen already, no? In which state particular things are there. Then program counter, in a computer organization, you have seen the program counter, no? Seen it?
Yes, sir.
Right. CPU registers, CPU scheduling information, priorities, whether your program has a high priority, low priority, right? All that information that is being stored here, we'll see as and when we proceed to the next semester in detail. Then, see, when your program, see, is running, see here, running, probably you may have to wait for something, right? When you are waiting, CPU doesn't wait for you. What it will do, it will pick another program and start running, right? This is called scheduling. A doctor, when you go to a doctor, right, all patients are waiting outside. You'll pick one patient. Then he will check something. He says that when you get your blood tested, go out. And once it is ready, come back again. Then when that patient has gone out, they're only in the next room for blood test. A doctor will pick another patient. He will test something. Then he'll say, no, you get your x-ray done. Go to the next room. And again, he will pick the another patient. Then the first patient who has completed his blood test, right, he's waiting. The doctor will pick, oh, come with your report. We'll see it. So he will keep on this process. This activity is called scheduling. Right? This process. So the new process is swapped in. The old process is swapped out. Swap in, swap out. It will happen. Right? Right. And the CPU is allocated to different process at different time, right, until it terminates, right? We call this as scheduling, and the one which does is called scheduler. One which does is called scheduler, right? There are, okay, three types of scheduler. One is long-term scheduler, right? Okay, you are gone to the hospital, right? So people will admit you inside. People will admit you inside by giving your token number, whatever that is there. That is the responsibility of a long-term scheduler. It will select a process from this pool, okay? And gets inside. Then there is a short-term scheduler, right? People who are waiting inside on the bench, right? They will be called inside and doctor is allocated to them. A short-term scheduler. Right? Yes. Right. So this is how it happens. Right? So look into this. 1 minute. Here, look into that. The process, look at the cursor. When a job is getting admitted into the system, when you call EXEC, memory is allocated and it comes and sits here, ready queue. Then from the ready queue, there are n number of program process waiting. It will pick one of that, CPU is allocated. And if its turn is over, it will push that one into one of the thing, waiting for an interrupt, fork a child, time slice expired. Okay, it will not, doctor will not see you, okay, until your entire case is over. No, he will give only 5 seconds time to you. Then you have to, your time is over, then you have to come and sit in the ready queue. And again, doctor will pick another patient. So like that, all patient in a round robin fashion, he will look into that. Okay, this is called process scheduling or CPU scheduling. But there are different varieties of CPU scheduling that we are not studying here this time. We'll study that in the next semester. Right? I think this is enough for you. Remaining all, we will see it again next semester. All details of that, we will see next semester. Right? So this is about the process management, which then we will get into the memory management, okay, tomorrow, and remaining aspect of preparation for the internal exam one, right? And on Friday, okay, lab examination, lab, what we'll do is all program will try to revise it, right, for the IO1 preparation, because programs are more important. Programs are more important. And sometimes theoretical stuff like state diagram, right, process control block, explain different information stored in the process control block. What is process control block and why it is required? Explain the various information stored in the process control block. Some theoretical stuff also you may get it. But program will be there. So on Friday in the laboratory slot, we'll try to look, revise at the program. If any doubts are there, I'll open every program starting from command line argument to EXEC, get PID, get parent ID, EXEC, fork, V fork, right? Then sleep, right? Then what else? LSTAT, STAT, read, write, open, close, right? All that system calls until attributes of the file directory listing. Until directory listing, everything is there, program. That we'll try to revise on Friday. All of you join. And if you have any queries, any questions, you can ask me at the time. I'll answer it. Right? So I think probably, I mean, you ask your next course teacher to start taking class now immediately. Right? Then afterwards, I think Anand the Vaith is taking for about the examination, it seems. He's called for the meeting, it seems. Right? So, Manoj and Imarashmi, I'll be stopping here now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tomorrow we'll meet and look at the memory management revision. Then on Friday, this week, we are doing only revision. I'm not getting into the next chapter for the IA2, which I could have done it. I have done it for the fifth semester. Already, we have covered 50% of IA2 portion for the fifth sem. I don't want to do it for you, right? Because first time, a lot of C programming issues are there for you, right? So let me get into entire week revision only. Got it, right? So tomorrow revision of memory. Then afterwards, on Friday, I'll revise about all programs which are important for internal exam one. Don't miss it, right? If you miss the programming, okay, you are losing around 10 to 12 marks, right? That's. Shall I close this? Shall I end my meeting?
Yes, sir.
Imarashmi, I'll close my meeting.
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay. Bye. Bye.